This is one of my backup catfish reels, an Outback Mitchell. You might see it in the old videos, like my little bluegill video, one of my first ones. Yeah, so that is my surf reel. Akuma Stratus XTS, big giant reel spooled with a 12-pound test Cajun. Big reel. It's real nice. I use it for fish. Compare that to my hand. I got an 8-inch hand. Pretty big. Here is my Boo Garcia Silver Max spooled with 12-pound Cajun Red tied onto a Cinco. That's why I'm making a video later of fishing. Little reel grips. 6'6" Berkeley Lightning Rod. Well, this is my new camera if no one ever noticed because it's real nice looking. Made by Berkeley. Great reel and rod combo. I got it for $70 at Bass Pro Shops. I mean, not Bass Pro, but Dick's. Here's my newest, but ones I've messed with a lot. Well, messed up a lot, I mean, for red fishing. My Fluger, what are you called? I can't pronounce you. But can anyone read that? Tell me how it's pronounced or something. Yeah, spooled with 15-pound Power Pro. All-Star Rods. How long are you? I don't know. 6'7", something. I don't know. $117 combo at Dick's. Great for red fishing. And I have another big caster rod, a Berkley Lightning Rod, 7-foot medium heavy action with the Daiwa Mega Force reel. It's at mom's house, and a Boo Garcia 660, which got stolen. And then this is a spinner rod I just use when I get bored. It's in a Hurricane Atuiga Redbone series. 7-foot rod, medium action, with a Daiwa reel, with a 12-pound trilene. Last time I used it for catfishing, got a clear bobber, because I was fishing with so many other people. I want to know where my line is so I don't get tangled up. We'll start going. Then right here is one of my favorite rods. It's a Daiwa D-Shock. It's cheap rod, but actually pretty good if you learn how to use it without breaking it. Then there's a Gander Mountain Pro Select. Had it for almost a year now, and it's still great. 8-pound test trilene with a Roadrunner. Great for crappie. That's what I've been fishing with for, bluegill, warmouth, and them little things. And if you ever watch my old videos, you ever see this, the rod with the Mighty Putty? Yeah, this is that rod. That goes to that reel. The Shakespeare 40, I got the ugly stick a while back. I just use it for catfishing, like pond catfishing stuff, because I want to use all my good rods. And I'm okay with this getting messed up. Then here's my ugly stick I use for big catfish. 6'6", I think, or 7-foot. I feel like looking. And here's my other rod I use for shark fishing. Now here's my tackle box stuff. All right, down here, Storm Kicking Minnow. Little Yuzuri little minnow thingamajigger. Rapala original floater, whatever. Another one, different color. Crankbait got from Eric. Another little jerk bait, little cricket. A little crappie marabou jig. A Rebel Popar, my first hard bait, and I still never caught a fish on it. And it has no hooks. I got the thing 2 years ago. This is a rattle trap, I think raw fish color, rattle trap. You can tell a big fish has been eating that. We caught a gar and a bowfin on that one. You can tell, look on the scratch marks. Bleeding Shad Rapala. I think that's some Bleeding Shad again. This is, I don't know, got it from friend Alex. Here's another, did I say Rapala? Rattle trap, I mean, I'm sorry. Something else, can't remember what it's called, popper. I got those walk the dog type baits, like Zero Spooks. This is a Super Spook. This is a Rapala, I can't remember the name, but it's just like them, walk the dog. Here's another one, Strout Collar, that's a some herring color. It's a Rapala, Shad Wrapper? No, I don't think it's Shad Wrap, I can't remember the name. I think this is the Shad Wrap right here, Deep Dives. Bluegill color, baby bass color, crawfish color, join in, all that good stuff. Something I got from my friend Ricky. He gave it to me for free. And this is a Berkley Frenzy little thing I use for crappie. It's really small. See, it's like smaller than my thumb. Yeah. And this is a crankbait, Strike King. Something shad. It's really good though in deep water and ponds. Oh, I had this thing forever. It's a man's baby minus one or whatever crankbait. Here's a crankbait I got from my friend Mikey. Another crankbait from Bass Pro Shops I got from Mikey. And a little cheap crankbait just like that for crappie. And here's a joining Rapala. Pretty big. It's big for saltwater and stuff. And snooks and all them things. We got a Rapala. Can't remember what it's called. I had this thing forever. Hooks came out. Bill popped out. Rapala. Can anyone remember what it's called? I have not remember what the name. I know it's a slash bait though. X-Wrap. Yeah, Rapala X-Wrap. And then here's a Rapala Husky Jerk. Another Rapala X-Wrap. The smaller Husky Jerks. These are my colors. All colors, so you know. Black and white. Here's a True Tungsten True Life Swim Bait. 4 inches. You know, four of my fingers. Bluegill color. Great bait. Put little BBs in there and sing. Look at that. That's nice. Look in the video later. So, in a slideshow, my friend caught up. How big was it? 11.6 pound bass on it. In the pond. People don't think ponds have big bass, but ponds around here got giant bass because this used to be a farm where we live. And it was a farm for 60 something years. So, they got some big ass bass. What is this called? Strike King. Something Kevin Van Damme used it though. It's big and it catches big bass. And saltwater fish. This is a sexy swimmer. I tie leaders to these kind of things. You know, a 30 pound leader and a 65 pound swivel. Just so I don't lose my bait. And here's a homemade chatterbait of mine. Homemade, yeah, I made it look so pretty. Here's one of the jigs, a booyah jig. Another booyah jig, it's a football head. Another booyah jig, it's a football head, a little longer, because it makes the camera longer. Swimming jig, a little weather. This is a homemade punch bait. Right here. I made a lightweight fucking let it hit the ground a little softer. And this is a saltwater jig. Jeez. And that's a little mini jig crappie. That's another homemade chatterbait of mine. And this is actually really good for redfish. It's a tube worm melted together with a swimming finger. Long, but it catches big fish. Here's the hooks I usually mainly use. Yamagatsu 2, 1, 1, 2, and 3 ounce hooks. A little rotary jig head. Here's all other boxes just to have stuff in them. Strike King spinnerbait, little mini thing. And the crawfish I'm gonna use right when it gets warm, because it's like 30 something degrees out here. Here's a swim bait, a mini thing, cream spoiler shad. Here's a Yamamoto Cinco. Another big Yamamoto Cinco. Little spinnerbait with a little tail. Really good salt water. A little worm. Big old cream spoiler shads, marabou jig and stuff. Another jig head, a frog, marabou jig. We got some other box that I like to use a lot. Some Cinco's. And some next one. Really good for shaky heading. No more Cinco's, like smaller sizes. Here's the other favorite color on the beach, South Florida. Here's another color. A little rubber worm. And it's a little mini Cinco. 3 inches long. My friend caught a bass and he put it with a hot dog. Surprise. And here's a Rage Tail Strike King. Strike King Rage Tail. Smells like waffles. I don't know why it smells like waffles. And this is a Yum Money Frog. I haven't seen many people use this. But you think a horny toad's good. This kills horny toads. Even though horny toad's a classic. Yum Houdini. Money Houdini. Who got one of them besides me? That's sticky. It's a walk. It's a soft plastic. See? Walk the dog type bait underwater. What you got on that one, man? Here's a striking little money minnow. The rattletail. Rattling tail. Here's the hook. It's called the money hook. It's a big hook. See, look at that. The hell, there's some birds in my garage. Then there's a little swim bait got from Eric. Small muddy thing. Probably feels long, but I got a lot of stuff. A few jig heads, homemade fly, and then just the extra crap.